Welcome to the first derivative test. The goal of this video will be to find relative extrema of a function using the first derivative. This presentation assumes you've already watched the video entitled Increasing and Decreasing Functions. Let's go ahead and get started. The first derivative test for relative extrema. F of x has a relative minimum at c if f of x is decreasing to the left of c and increasing to the right. So if the function is going downhill, and then uphill to the left and right of C, we'll call this C, we would have to have a low point or a relative minimum. From the previous video, we also know that this would occur where the derivative changes from negative to positive. Negative derivative means the function is decreasing. Positive derivative means it's increasing. And if the opposite occurs, if a function changes from increasing to decreasing at c, we'd have a high point or a relative maximum. And again, the derivative would change from positive to negative in this case. And sometimes the sign of the first derivative won't change. If you take a look at this function, it's increasing and then increasing again. So we'd have a positive derivative to the left and right of c. And in this case, we have neither a relative max or a min. So this is what we're going to do to find the relative extrema using the first derivative. Step one, we are going to locate any critical values of the function, and we use these numbers to determine our test intervals. Number two, we'll determine the sign of the first derivative. And as we learned from a previous video, if the first derivative is positive, it's increasing on the interval, and if it's negative, it's decreasing. Step four, based upon the sign changes of the derivative, we'll determine if any relative extrema exist. And then if the relative extrema exists, we'll evaluate the original function at the given x value to find the relative max or min. Let's go ahead and give it a try. Determine any relative extrema using the first derivative. So step one, we're going to find the derivative to find the critical numbers. The derivative would be equal to 3/4 x squared minus 3. There are no values of x where this does not exist, so we'll set it equal to 0 and solve. To clear the fractions here, what we could do is multiply through by 4. If we did that, we would obtain 3x squared minus 12 is equal to 0. Factor out the common factor of 3. Factor the difference of squares. Looks like we have two critical numbers. We have x equal to 2 and x equals negative 2. Since the domain of the original function is all reals, we're going to have three intervals to test. Here they are. From negative infinity to negative 2, from negative 2 to 2, and from 2 to infinity. Let's pick our test values. To determine the sign of the first derivative, I'm going to go ahead and use the graphing calculator again. We will type in the derivative function into y1. Remember, the derivative was 3/4 x squared minus 3. Using the table feature, we can find the sign of the first derivative. If we hit second graph, we can type in our test values of negative 3, 0, and 3. The first interval is positive, the second is negative, and the third is positive. Let's go ahead and record that information. So what we know is that it's increasing on this interval, decreasing and increasing. Now that's not what they ask us here, but if it changes from increasing to decreasing, we'd have a relative max at x equals negative 2. And if it changes from decreasing to increasing here, we'd have a low point or relative minimum at positive 2. So let's go ahead and record this down below. Again, our relative max is at x equals negative 2, and our minimum was at x equals 2. Now the actual relative max and min are the y values of the function at these values of x. So we actually have to find f of 2 and f of negative 2. So we have to evaluate the original function at these values of x. Our original function was x cubed divided by 4 minus 3x. So now using the table feature again, we'll evaluate this at negative 2 and 2. So at negative 2, the y value is 4. At positive 2, it's equal to negative 4. So our relative max is equal to 4 at x equals negative 2. Our relative minimum is equal to negative 4 at x equals positive 2. Let's verify this with a graph. And you can see here's our relative max. Here's our relative min. Looks like our work is good. I hope that helps explain how to find the relative extrema using the first derivative. Thank you for watching.